It's Julia, and today I'm going to be doing kind of like a how to start a BookTube / Bookstagram video. Before I start on like the advice that I would give to people who want to start a BookTube channel, I want to kind of tell you why I started a BookTube channel. So the reason why I started a BookTube channel, long story short, is that I wanted to be a writer. I've always been an avid reader. I read probably one or two books a month. It wasn't my top priority, but one day I was pondering as to what I want to do with my life. My husband said, focus on something that you want to do, not something that you have to do. And so I started thinking about it, and one thing that I've always consistently loved throughout my life was reading. So I thought, how could I turn that into a career? So I thought, maybe I'll become a writer. So I started looking up ways to become a writer on YouTube, or how to start writing a book. What I found was Jenna Maresi, who is a authortuber, and I watched pretty much every video that she'd ever made and loved every single one of them, and it gave me a lot of inspiration to start writing a book. So while I was watching Jenna Maresi's channel, I saw in like the suggested videos some BookTubers and wondered what they were, so I clicked on them and ended up finding Haley and Bookland. So Haley and Bookland is another BookTuber who has, I think she has somewhere around a little over 100,000 subscribers, something like that. She's pretty big in the BookTube community, and I love all of her videos. So after watching some of her videos and some other BookTubers' videos, I decided, I want to do this. I have no experience in front of a camera. I'm totally awkward, but I want to do this. So after about 3 weeks of going back and forth on whether or not I should start a channel, I decided to just go ahead and do it. So I got out my laptop, brought up, what is it, iPicture photo booth or whatever, and I recorded my first video, which I believe was a book haul. It was totally dorky, but I'm glad that I did it, and I just started posting videos, I think once a week from there on. I really loved doing it. That is pretty much how I started BookTube, and now I'm going to go into some advice that I have for people who want to start a channel. From learning from my own experiences and being on BookTube for a little over a year now, I'm not a professional BookTuber. Obviously, I don't have a gazillion subscribers or anything like that, but I wanted to kind of put my two cents in from my experiences and help people who want to start a BookTube channel. The first thing that I would say is don't have really big expectations of, you know, I'm doing BookTube because I want to have a bunch of subscribers. I want to do BookTube because I want to make a bunch of money. I want to do BookTube because I want to get free books. Those things are not going to happen when you're just starting out, or even in the first couple of years that you're doing BookTube. I've been doing BookTube for a year now and just recently started getting ARCs, but the only reason why I get ARCs is because I have my own book subscription box, so they send me those so that I can read them and decide if I want to put them in my box or not. I don't get them because I have a ton of followers or because my BookTube channel is amazing. I'm even somebody who requested them a lot. I avidly emailed publishers and asked for books and never got them. So not until I started a book box did I actually start getting ARCs. Also, I mean, don't have expectations that you're gonna make a lot of money, because you seriously have to have, like, I think it's like 1 million subscribers to be someone who makes a couple grand a month. It's not something that you're gonna make a ton of money off of. I mean, if you do, that's great. More power to you. But, you know, that shouldn't be your expectation going into doing BookTube, is getting free stuff or making money off of BookTube. You should do it because you want to help spread the word about books, or, you know, help people find new books, or even just express your love for books, because a lot of us readers don't have a lot of people we can talk to about books, because it's kind of a hobby that only a select few people have. You either love reading or you don't like reading. That's kind of my experience. I think if you go into BookTube wanting to make friends and have fun, you're gonna go further in the BookTube community than rather if you're like, I wanna have a bunch of subscribers. I want to make money. I only want to do this because I want free books. Because I don't feel like people who, I don't want to offend anybody, but I feel like people who are like that, they don't make as many friends, and people don't really want to watch their channels. They want to see people who actually love reading and have a passion for it. I also want to talk about like spamming. You don't want to go, when you're first starting your channel and you want subscribers, you don't want to go on people's channels and go in the comment section and be like, hey, go look at my channel, or hey, I'm new, go look at my channel. The best way that you're gonna get subscribers from going onto people's videos and commenting is not to do that. You don't want to do that. You want to show interest in other people, and then they'll show interest in you. You want to try to make friends, and then those people are going to want to check out your channel. From my experience, that's what I've found to be the case. You always want to get on people's channels and give support and show interest in their channels. Just be trying to make friends. I can't stress that enough. Making friends on BookTube is such a great thing. I've made so many great friends on BookTube. Some of my best friends are people that I met on BookTube. Also, it takes time to build an audience. You are not going to get 100 subscribers overnight. I think it took me 6 months to get, not 6 months, that's exaggerating. It took me 4 months maybe to get my first 100 subscribers, because I feel like those first 100 are the hardest to get, because it's like nobody knows of you. You don't have a ton of videos out. So when people look at your channels, they're like, But once you get those first 100 subscribers, then people start to notice your channel more, and then it kind of is like a snowball effect of sorts. Also, if you don't focus on that as being your main priority of BookTube and you don't get discouraged by it, then you're gonna be less likely to give up on BookTube. Whereas if you stress about your subscribers and nobody wants to watch your channel and this and that, then you're gonna end up giving up on BookTube, because you don't get subscribers just like that. Like, it is a slow build, very slow build. And sometimes you'll have periods of time. I get periods of time where I don't get subscribers for a week, and I'm like, oh my God. But seriously, sometimes you'll go through dry patches where nobody subscribes to your channel, or just as many people unsubscribe as they subscribe. And that's okay, because it's not a big deal. Just have fun and the audience will come. I want us to stress to people too that BookTube is not easy. It is something you have to commit to and really like doing, otherwise it's not gonna work. BookTube is work in the sense of you have to stay committed to a schedule. And like me, I do it 3 times a week, every other day, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Posting regularly is a very important thing when you start a BookTube channel, because the more you post, the more videos you have on your channel, the more likely you are to get noticed. Also, editing is work. Some days it takes me 2 to 3 hours to edit a video, depending on how long the video is and how fluently I talk in that video, because sometimes I gotta cut out 20 million ands, ums, and buts before I can post a video. And it's a pain in the butt, but it's worth it when you have a video all come together and people love that video and people comment on your videos and really interact with you. It makes it all worth it. Now, some people might say, how do I make friends? I'm this awkward person, or I don't talk very well to other people. And I would say the best way to make friends is, number one, make a Twitter account. Make a Twitter account, start interacting with people on their videos and then reposting them on Twitter and tagging them in it. Then they see that you're doing that and supporting them, and they'll want to interact with you more. Or even just sending a message and being like, hey, I'm new to BookTube, trying to meet some new people. That is a great way to start making friends. Some of my friends that I have all started BookTube right around the same time as me, and those people, we've kind of grown our channels together and help support each other throughout our journey in BookTube, and that is great. And it seems like a lot of people do that. They find like their people, their best friends on BookTube, and then they stay together and support each other throughout. And it's a really cool thing, and I'm really glad that I have my people. Obviously, like I said, you know, comment on other people's videos, show people that you're a person and that you want to interact, and that'll help you meet new people. So I really think that's all for this video. If you like this video, please like and subscribe if you're not already, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.